And now, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to move ahead with the show. And I would like to invite Dr. Sunita Dubey for the felicitation of Sri Dr. Harshvardhan, Union Minister of Health and Family Welfare, Government of India. Now, ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Sunita Dubey is a radiologist, founder, chairperson, Medscape India, chairperson of organizing committee, Next Gen Summit, and a healthcare entrepreneur. More than 5 lakh COVID patients impacted under her We Doctors campaign across country, along with 12,000 volunteers, doctors since 14 months. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to, this was Dr. Sunita Dubey for you. Ma'am, over to you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. So I'm going to read about a citation for Dr. Harshvardhan. So Dr. Harshvardhan, Union Minister for Health and Family Welfare, Science and Technology and Earth Science, has long distinguished record of public service, leaving his indelible mark in all field of activity undertaken. And an ENT surgeon by profession, Dr. Harshvardhan branched out into public life in 1993, thus marking beginning of electoral politics. We saw him getting elected to the Delhi Assembly for 4 more successive terms in 1998, 2003, 2008, and 2013, and to the Lok Sabha in 2014 and in 19. Dr. Vardhan's public life has been marked by outstanding achievement in the field of health, education, law, science, technology, and environment. At the center stage of managing the present COVID crisis in India, Dr. Harshvardhan graded preemptive and proactive approach in strengthening health infrastructure, building capacity has been helping India through unprecedented health crisis. His exemplary work in combating the pandemic in this densely populated country has won him applause across the world and even lauded by World Health Organization. Under his able leadership, India took all necessary steps well in time, including surveillance at the point of entry, evacuation of national stranded overseas, massive community surveillance through robust disease surveillance network, risk communication, and community involvement to ensure that India does not lose the battle against coronavirus. COVID India Seva, a 24-hour helpline introduced by his ministry, provided an interactive platform to establish a direct two-way channel of communication with millions of Indians who have become victims of new deadly virus. This helpline is an initiative between the ministry and Twitter India and has enabled transparent e-governance deliverable in real time, answering citizen queries swiftly at scale, especially in crisis situation like the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic. Considering the current situation as well, we are very positive that you will be able to continue to contain the surge and manage the pandemic with your able leadership. In recognition of your role in handling pandemic under very difficult circumstances to oversee timely preventive measures and lowering the mortality rate, the IMC Chamber of Commerce and Industry applauds your contribution to the public health and felicitate you as a game changer of India. Sir, heartiest congratulations. Thank you so much for sparing today your time because it was really very difficult. Thank you so much. Heartiest congratulations once again, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Dubey.
So there is a video which Dr. Harshvardhan has sent to the IMC Health Summit, and we are going to play that. Okay, thank you. Please play the video.
Ladies, gentlemen, and my dear professional colleagues, a very good day to all of you. As we are all aware, these are indeed trying times for our country. Keeping in view the unprecedented surge in COVID-19 cases over the past few weeks, the situation seems overwhelming once again, but this time we are better informed about the threat we are dealing with. We have the tools to tackle it, and I am confident that with our whole of government and whole of society approach, we shall once again overcome the challenges posed by the recent wave of this pandemic. Together, we shall emerge stronger and even more resilient. In this regard, I truly appreciate IMC Chamber of Commerce and Industry for hosting this Next Gen Health Summit, Reimagine Healthcare, to take forward the dialogue on the future of our health system and how to make it more resilient. I am pleased to note the participation of numerous luminaries and experts from healthcare and allied fields at this forum, and look forward to fruitful outcomes of your deliberations. Friends, COVID-19 has laid bare the many fallacies in the health systems across the globe. It has also brought health at the center stage of public policy making. We must take advantage of this spotlight and make use of the collective resolve to build resilient healthcare systems of the future, which are able to quickly and decisively tackle any threats facing humankind while also delivering on the ultimate goal of health for all. Affordability and accessibility will be the key to establishing a healthcare system which can withstand shocks such as the current pandemic. One thing that has become clear from the current pandemic is that no one will be safe till everyone is safe. Hence, equitable healthcare delivery is essential to ensure health and well-being of each and every person. We must not only focus on being prepared to face the next pandemic, God forbid, if it ever comes in our lifetimes, but must also emphasize on preventing the next one. This can only be achieved by embracing technology, transparency, and adopting a holistic approach towards health. We have seen rapid development of technologies over the last decade, which have yielded great benefits during this pandemic as well. Advancements in technology have not only helped in expediting medical interventions, such as development of multiple vaccines for COVID-19 in record time, but also helped in ensuring continuity of healthcare delivery even during lockdowns. Transparency and expediting transmission of accurate information is of utmost importance. It will ensure that proactive steps are taken to address any emerging threat and ascertain its containment. A holistic approach to health is the need of the hour. Preventive and promotive health is even more important than curative health. Mental health, physical fitness, right nutrition, sanitation, personal hygiene, and respiratory etiquettes are crucial aspects for the overall well-being of an individual. Building mass movements around them and sensitizing the general public about the benefits of focusing on these aspects will go a long way in improving the health outcomes for society at large. Many of my government's programs are already working on these facets of healthcare. Our ambitious Ayushman Bharat program is the largest health assurance scheme in the world, striving to deliver universal health coverage while also promoting holistic health through its network of over 75,000 Ayushman Bharat health and wellness centers across the nation. We intend to further expand this number to 1,50,000 by the end of year 2022. Our Fit India, Swachh Bharat, Eat Right India programs have enjoyed huge success in building mass public movements around health and well-being. Friends, the most important aspect of any healthcare system is its healthcare workers. We have made numerous policy interventions in the last few years to streamline and upskill our healthcare workforce to build a modern, futuristic healthcare system on their able shoulders. The role our healthcare workers have played in fighting the battle against COVID-19 for more than 14 months now is praiseworthy, and no words can ever express our gratitude towards them. They have sacrificed their mental, physical, and emotional well-being for protecting the lives of others. We shall forever be indebted to them for their tireless and selfless service. These are certainly unprecedented times for all of us. This once-in-a-century health crisis has shook us to the core. It has also emboldened our resolve to use our collective strength to take all challenges head-on and move forward. It is a result of collaborative efforts of all stakeholders that the world's largest vaccine drive going on in the country has been progressing at a rapid pace. We have been the fastest in the world to administer more than 12 crore doses. Just yesterday, at a meeting headed by our Prime Minister, Shri Narendra Modi ji, a decision was taken to liberalize this procurement, pricing, and administering of COVID-19 vaccines policy in the country. All citizens above the age of 18 shall now be eligible to get vaccinated against COVID-19 from May 1, 2021. This will further accelerate the pace of our vaccine drive while incentivizing existing and new players to ramp up production in the country. Friends, this pandemic continues to be dynamic and is evolving each day. Our strategies too are being shaped proactively in line with these changes in consultation with field experts. Today, India is reporting another spike of COVID-19 in many states. It is an extremely challenging task to contain a virus as contagious as this in a country like ours, which has a very high population density in big cities and towns. Given these challenges, I can assure you that we are much better prepared today than we were in 2020, and we are doing everything we can to bring it under control with timely steps to break the chain of transmission and expand the vaccination drive across the country. While we continue to deal with this grave challenge, we must also work towards our larger goal of preventing, tackling, and being better prepared for another health crisis of such magnitude in the future. Medscape India has come out with a great idea of Statue of Immunity, along with a research and information center on immunity to fight future pandemic. I wish them great success. I would like to end by urging everyone to sincerely practice and propagate COVID-appropriate behavior and follow all COVID-related guidelines so that together we can successfully fight this pandemic. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to address this esteemed gathering. Stay safe.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. We are extremely humbled and honored.